Survival analysis and Kaplan Meier curve. Clinical trials describe how an outcome is affected by exposure. Incidence rates describe the effect of exposure on the outcome. The majority of clinical studies are designed so that the desired endpoint can be reached in a short enough period of time to ensure that all observations can be made with minimal dropout and with an effect that is fairly constant over time. However, sometimes the desired outcome cannot be observed in the short term, or the final observed proportion of events between two treatment groups is identical. In such cases, another technique that considers the time until an event occurs will develop much more clinical information than whether or not the event occurred. For example, if one group had all events occur shortly after randomization, while the other had no events until just before the end of follow-up, then the two treatments would logically be considered to have different clinical effects despite the identical proportions at the end of follow-up. So, what is survival analysis? Survival analysis is a collection of statistical procedures for data analysis where the outcome variable of interest is the time until an event occurs. This means that survival analysis measures the time between a starting point and an ending point. This statistical method has originated in the field of medical research for evaluating the impact of medicines or medical procedures on time until death, which is the typical example of survival analysis. In fact, survival is not exclusively meaning survival from death, may be also applied to the time survived from complete remission to relapse or progression. The process of survival analytics can be explored through various techniques such as survivor and hazard function rates, Cox proportional hazards regression analysis, parametric survival analytic models, survival trees, survival random forest, life tables, and Kaplan-Meier curve. Now let's talk more about Kaplan-Meier curve. The Kaplan-Meier curve is a visual representation of survival function that shows the probability of an event at a respective time interval. This statistical method perfectly matches effective cancer treatments. Let's take an example. Suppose that a new drug is developed to treat lung cancer. To evaluate this new drug, test subjects are divided into two groups. The first one takes a placebo and the other take the new drug. Let's say that the number of subjects in each arm are 100, and the study duration is 30 months. Each group starts taking the assigned medicine according to the study design at the starting point until the end of the 30 months. All subjects within each group begin the analysis at the same point, and all are surviving until something happens to one of them. Either a subject can have the event of interest, or they are censored. In this example, event occurrence means subject death. On the other hand, censoring means the total survival time for that subject cannot be accurately determined. This can happen when something negative for the study occurs, such as the subject dropping out, lost to follow-up, or required data is not available. Or conversely, something good happens, such as the study ends before the subject had the event of interest occur, which means they survived at least until the end of the study, but there is no knowledge of what happened thereafter. Thus, censoring can occur within the study or terminally at the end. Now, let's look at the Kaplan-Meier curve. The horizontal line along the x-axis of serial time represents the survival duration for that interval. The interval is terminated by the occurrence of the event of interest. The vertical line along the y-axis represents the survival rate. We can look for gaps in these curves in a horizontal or vertical direction. A vertical gap means that at a specific time point, one group had a greater fraction of subjects surviving. A horizontal gap means that it took longer for one group to experience a certain fraction of deaths. As we can see the vertical gap here at week 22, placebo group had a greater fraction of subjects surviving, despite that the overall results represented by the horizontal gap shows that the new drug arm has greater survival rate of 43% compared to placebo group of 0% survival at the end of the trial. However, in order to say that there is a significant difference between the two groups, confidence interval should be at least 95%. It is also recommended to calculate other statistical measures such as the p-value and the hazard ratio to confirm statistical significance.
Thank you.